بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We begin in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all forms of praise because only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is worthy and deserving of praise. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His choicest blessings and mercies upon our beloved master and guide, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his pure and chaste wives, his noble and beloved companions, and all those who follow in the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam until the day of Qiyamah. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I had a conversation with a friend of mine earlier in the week, and it was a very deep discussion, very basic, you know, regarding the basic society that we live in. What influences people and their thought, their practices, their character, their behaviors, their prejudices. And he made a statement which I may have heard before, but it never struck me as deep as it did that day. And he said to me, show me your friends. Show me your friends and I will show you your future. Show me your friends and I will show you your future. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Furqan, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا يَا وَيْلَتَى لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِلْإِنسَانِ خَذُولًا. صدق الله العظيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks in Surah Al-Furqan and he says that on the day of Qiyamah, the oppressor will be biting at his fingers. He will be gnawing at his hands and he will be saying, woe unto me, if only I had taken a path with the Messenger of Allah. If only I had followed the path of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يَا وَيْلَتَى لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا. If only destruction be to me, if only I had not taken so and so as my friend. Why? لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ. He had led me astray. He took me away from the reminder. He took me away from deen. He took me away from the Qur'an al-Kareem. He took me away from the sunnah. بعد إذ جاءني. After it had come to me. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it in my path. This man led me astray. وَكَانَ شَيْطَانُ لِلْإِنسَانِ خَذُولًا. And shaytan through his devious ways will always be there to misguide and disgrace the insan. After all, he made a promise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there's a very interesting sabab nuzul, the reason for these verses, the reason they were revealed unto Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we will discuss a little bit about the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam today. In the Meccan period of the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there was an individual by the name of Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayt. And there were also individuals, two brothers by the names of Umayyah bin Khalaf and Ubay bin Khalaf. All of these were from the most severe of the mushrikeen against Islam. They had caused tremendous difficulty to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They had given Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam an extremely hard time. They inflicted severe harm, physical bodily harm to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the interesting thing is, Ubay bin Khalaf used to come to the majlis of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to frequent the gatherings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He would sit there. He would listen to the speech of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But he did not accept Islam. He did not accept Islam. He had indicated on one occasion that he wants to accept Islam. Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayt said to him, your face is haram for my face if I find out that you have followed the path of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yani, I don't ever want to see you again in my life. If I find out that you have followed Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I don't ever want to see your face. لا أريد أن أرى وجهك. Your face is haram for my face. So he did not accept Islam. Now it was the practice of this Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayyad that when he would go on a journey, when he would come back from a business trip or from whatever safar that he was on, he would make food, he would have a feast, and he would invite all the leaders of the Quraysh to come and partake of this meal. So on one particular occasion, he had come back from a journey, he made some food, and he invited all of the leaders of the Quraysh that come and participate in this meal, come and sit and have a feast with me. He also invited Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came. So what happened is, the food was presented. The Ashraf from the Quraysh, the leaders from the Quraysh were eating. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not eat. He asked him, why are you not eating, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He says, I will not participate in your meal until you do not testify that there is no deity worthy of worship other than Allah, and that I am the messenger of Allah. So he said, you know, Rasulullah, I have been wanting to embrace Islam. I have been wanting to embrace Islam. So he said, then embrace Islam so that we participate in your meal. So he read the kalima. He testified that there is no one worthy than worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ate. Afterwards, his friend Umayyah bin Khalaf finds out that Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayyad has accepted Islam and he is following Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He comes to him and says, Ya Uqba, Asabat, Uqba, are you leaving the deen of your forefathers? You're the leader of your nation and you are leaving the religion of your forefathers. He says, you know what? We are feeding the leaders here. I was ashamed that there was someone in my gathering that refused to eat my food. I was embarrassed that someone has come to my house and he's not participating in my meal. So to make Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam happy, I read the kalima so that he could eat my food. So he says, I don't believe you. I don't believe you. Go now to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There are different narrations on this particular part. One narration says, he told Uqba, go to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sway at him, insult him, then I will believe you. According to the narration, he went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He swore Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He insulted him alayhi salatu wa sallam, and he rejected his deen. According to another narration, he says, Uqba, go to Muhammad. Go to Muhammad, spit in his face. Na'udhu billahi.
Allah.
Spit in his face, step on his neck. Then I will believe you. According to the narration, he went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wafa'al. He did it. He spat in the Mubarak face of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He stepped on the Mubarak neck of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But what is amazing? What is amazing from the mu'ajizat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is mentioned according to one of the muhaddithin that when he spat in the face of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his spit returned to his own face and it splashed on his cheeks and it burnt his cheeks. And that mark remained on his face until he was killed. Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayyad is the one that was assassinated. He was executed rather after being captured at the Battle of Badr. Umayyah bin Khalaf and Ubay bin Khalaf, these were all killed. One was killed in the Battle of Uhud. One was killed in the Battle of Badr as well. They were all killed. They used to deny the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They used to say that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is kadhab. He is the one that there's nobody that lies more than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, despite the fact that they used to give him the title of As-Sadiqul Amin, the most truthful and the most trustworthy. They denied the message that he came with. But there was something in their hearts that they knew that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a truthful man. He never deceived anybody. He never spoke a lie. This is why they would still come to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and entrust him with their belongings. They would entrust him with their wealth because they knew they couldn't trust their own brethren from the mushrikeen, but they could trust Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, on one occasion there was one Sahabi, he was one of the leader of the Ansari, came from Medina Munawwara. He was a very close friend of Ubay bin Khalaf. So he came to Makkah al-Mukarramah. And he came and he came to perform the tawaf. This was after the hijrah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He came into Makkah al-Mukarramah. So as his habit was, he would go to the house of Ubay bin Khalaf. So Ubay bin Khalaf, being the leader of the Quraysh, understanding that his friend Sa'd bin Mu'adh, who is a leader of the Ansar of Medina, has protected Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they have given sanctuary to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Medina Munawwara, knowing that he is number one on the most wanted list of Makkah. He says to him, "Oh Sa'd, please, I know you're going to go and make tawaf of the Kaaba. Don't go now. Wait until it's a little bit hot, when the people have taken to their homes, and then you go and perform tawaf." Sa'd bin Mu'adh goes and he makes tawaf. Sa'd bin Mu'adh goes and he makes tawaf. And there is Abu Jahl. Abu Jahl comes there and he sees Sa'd bin Mu'adh. He says, "Who is this man? Who is this man making tawaf here in the middle of the day? As if there's nothing wrong." They knew that he was a leader of the Ansar. He says, "This man has the audacity to come here in Makkah and make tawaf, whereas he has given sanctuary to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." So Sa'd bin Mu'adh radiallahu anhu, he stops. He looks at Abu Jahl and they had an exchange. The hadith very politely records it, but there was an exchange of profanity. He insulted Abu Jahl insulted him, and they were exchanging insults until they came to a point where the friend of Sa'd bin Mu'adh, Ubay bin Khalaf, he tells him, "Oh Sa'd, do not raise your voice over the voice of Abu al-Hakam," he says. His name was Abu Jahl according to the Muslims. He says, "Do not raise your voice over his voice, because he's the leader of Makkah. He's the leader of the Quraysh." So he persisted. He says, "Oh Sa'd, don't raise your voice. He is our leader." He said to his own friend, Ubay bin Khalaf, he said to him, "My brother, if it was not for the fact that I was making tawaf right now, I would completely end your trade with Syria. I would completely cut off the trade that you do with Syria." Now remember, they were close friends. When he would go to Syria, he would stop in Medina by the house of Sa'd bin Mu'adh, and vice versa, they would do this through the trade. But he said, "I am prepared to end this relationship with you just because this man has despised me based on the fact that we have protected Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam." Bearing in mind, look at the courage and the strength of Iman of Sa'd bin Mu'adh radiallahu anhu. He was alone, single man making tawaf. Abu Jahl was there with all his cronies from amongst the mushrikeen. So these are these people that had caused this harm to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayyid is the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking about here in this verse, as the one that had misguided his friend. He is the one that had told his friend to go and do these obscenities to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And according to other narrations, it was the other way around, Ubay bin Khalaf. But in any case, these people will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah, and they will rue what they have done in their lives. They will be consumed with regret on the day of Qiyamah, when they have to answer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that they got the hidayah. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in their presence. He gave them the message. They heard his voice. They heard the da'wah from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yet they still rejected. This Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayyid, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was still in Mecca, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would go to the Kaaba, and he would go and perform two raka'at of salah, he would take off his shawl, and he would go and stand behind Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He would wrap his shawl around the Mubarak neck of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he would choke him. He would choke Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam while he is in salah. He would choke him severely. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would be in extreme discomfort, suffocating, but he would not retaliate. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu saw this happening. He came there, he grabbed Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayyid, and he threw him away from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, "Is this also become a crime now, that you are prepared to kill someone just because he says that my Rabb is Allah. The same Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayyib is the individual that went to take the intestines of a camel and dump it on the back of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was in Sajda. They had absolutely no respect for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he was captured on the day of Badr, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had given the instruction that this man has to be executed. He is an enemy of Islam, he is an enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, who is going to look after my children? He started pleading with them. He started begging them for mercy. Ali radiallahu anhu was the one. Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu was the one that struck the head of Uqba ibn Abi Mu'ayyib. He was executed. So like this, show me your friends and I will show you your future. This man had the option of befriending Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He had the option of becoming a Sahabi of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of getting the title of Allah, that Allah has given him the title of radiyallahu anhu wa radu anhu. This option was in front of him. All he had to do was make the choice, but he made the wrong choice. The reason he made the wrong choice was because of the company that he kept. Similarly, my brother and my sister in Islam, let us ask ourselves, the company that we keep, and understand company is not only the company that we have physically from the brothers and sisters that we have around us. I'm not talking necessarily about physical company, but the company that we have on our devices, the company that we have on social media. What is that company? Show me your friends and I will show you your future. Do we want to end up like those individuals? Who are the friends that we keep? What do you have to say about the individual that makes his friend the Quran al-Kareem? What do you have to say about the individual that makes his friend the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? The Seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? That makes his friends the Sahaba radiallahu anhum? What do you have to say about that person? I'll tell you what I have to say. And I will share with you what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith of Bukhari, Al-mar'u ma'a man ahabba. On the day of Qiyamah and in the Akhirah, you will be with those people whom you love. So if you truly love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you truly love the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, and you truly love this deen, you will stay in the sohbah and the company of this deen and the people who are associated to this deen and the people that remind you of this deen when you are in their company. And on the flip side of the coin, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. But if we befriend the wrong people, al-mar'u ala deeni khalili, a man will be on the path and the religion of his friends. فَلْيَنْظُمْ أَحَدُكُمْ مَنْ يُخَالِمْ. So be careful who you befriend, because you will end up like that person. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. How many times have we not seen youngsters in school? Bright youngster, intelligent young man, very promising future, but bad friends. He starts smoking. Some people can still argue, that's not so bad. Smoking, so many people smoke, it's fine. Then what happens? He starts smoking other things. Then from other things, it starts to small recreational drugs, as they call them nowadays. Lighter, it's nothing serious, nothing addictive, it's cheap. He can stop whenever he wants to. Maybe he's got a little problem, but you know, we will sit him down, we'll talk to him. Before you know it, the man is selling the furniture in his mother's house. He's selling his father's car to feed his drug habit. Why? Al-mar'u ala deeni khalili. I got a message the other day, it's about 2 weeks ago, La ilaha illallah, I couldn't believe my eyes. I read the message, two mayits in one community. What happened? The son shot his mother dead. Allah. Son shot his mother dead. The mother's brother, the uncle, comes to kill the son because he shot his sister. Two mayits, both of them Muslim. This is most probably because of a drug habit that he couldn't feed. He kept on taking his mother, he refused at some point, he lost his mind, he killed his own mother. Al-mar'u ala deeni khalili. How will this person stand in front of Allah on the day of Qiyamah? So my brother and my sister in Islam, we listen to these verses of the Quran al-Kareem and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us hidayah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the tawfiq inshaAllah to follow the path of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to adhere to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah bless us with the sohbah of the Quran. May Allah bless us with the sohbah of the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah bless us with the sohbah of the sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Read the seerah. Read the biographies of Sahaba, you will feel your iman increase. Read the Quran al-Kareem, you will feel your connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq, barakallahu feekum, wa akhiru da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.